Good morning to one and all. Today we are going to study about some of the concept about the paleontology. In last lecture we study about what exactly paleontology is, what is the different kind of branches of paleontology, and again what is the different kind of fossil we study. So today lecture is basically more focus on some of the phylums which we consider as a important one. So so this is how you can have what we can study about the different kind of fossils we get studied about. So now today's topic is what a brachiopods. Today's topic is brachiopods. So brachiopods is nothing but one of the what we can say, the one of the fossil of the or phylum which we study under the paleontology. So this is a typical brachiopod shell. This is a typical brachiopod shell which we divide it into the different part. Okay, this is a posterior side of the. So what exactly mean of the brachiopods? What is the exactly meaning of brachiopods? Brachio is a arm, or poda is a foot. Brachial is a arm, poda is a foot. So this is known as the brachiopods. So brachio is a arm and poda is a foot, that is known as brachiopod. So the organism characterized by arm and foot is called the brachiopods. So the organism which is characterized by the arm and foot is known as the brachiopods. Brachiopods is a phylum. Brachiopods is a phylum. They first appear in the beginning of the Cambrian and become abundant in the early Ordovician. They first appear in the beginning of the Cambrian and become abundant in the early Ordovician. They are exclusively a marine and sessile. The brachiopods are exclusively marine and sessile animals. So now what is the morphology of the brachiopods? What is the morphology of brachiopods? So whenever you study any organism, you have like you, if you study the human organism, human as a morphology of the human, you can have two hands and head, neck and all this part which we study. Heart, you have a heart, legs and all the things. This all are the nothing but a morphological characteristic of the human. Likewise, you have such a morphological characteristic of a different this brachiopods is also one of the phylum which we have studied and which we are going to see about that, what kind of part and what kind of the part of this phylum. So locopore, what is the locopore? Locopore is a soft part of the organism. Locopore is a soft part of the organism which is known as the pedicle and which is heart like organ, nerve ring, collectively known as the locopore. It is collectively called as the locopore. Locopore occur in pair with the cilia. Locopore occur in pair with the cilia and used for a gathering the food. Locopore is used to gathering the food. Hard part of the organism, hard part of the organism is known as the shell. The hard part of the locopore is nothing but a soft part of the organism, a soft part of the organism. So primarily brachiopods has two wall. Brachiopods have two wall. The wall are unequal and equilateral. The wall are equilateral. The wall are unequal and equilateral, giving rise to bilateral symmetry about the plane draw perpendicular to the linen of contract two walls. So this is how your what we can have a different kind of loco core, or what we have braccio cores. So this is a typical a sketch. This is a typical sketch of the organism. This is a typical sketch of the organism which we study under, which we studied. So this is the anterior and posterior side. Okay, you have anterior side as well as the posterior side. You have an anterior side as well as the posterior side. So anterior side is a or there is a, you have a two way views also and two side also. A smaller wall is called as the dorsal view. It's called as a wall, and brachial skeleton is attached to it, so also called as a brachial wall. Okay, so larger wall is a ventral wall, and the pedicle comes out through this wall, is soon also known as pedicle walls. Umbo, what is the umbo? Posterior protuberance, a posterior protuberance of each wall, it is a quite obvious that the umbo of ventral wall will be larger. Umbo of ventral wall will be the larger. Then you have a beak. Then you have a beak. Beak is a pointed extreme point of umbo. Okay. Then you have a hinge line. Like what hinge line you are in a pole and quartz. Same concept is here, hinge line. Line of junction of two wall. Same concept what you use in a hold, hold and whatever we are going to study about the hold and this all. So this is the line of junction of two wall. This is the line of junction of two wall at posterior margin. It may be straight or curved. It may be straight or curved. Then you have auricles. Then you have auricles. Auricles is an ear-like projection. Auricles is an ear-like projection from a hinge line shell which bears a auricles called a allied. Then you have a pedicle. Then you have a pedicle. A pedicle is a fleshy stalk called a pedicle. A pedicle is a fleshy stalk which called a pedicle used to attach with substrate. A fleshy stalk which is called a pedicle used to attach with substrate. Then you have a deltherium. Then you have a deltherium. Deltherium is a pedicle opening through triangular opening and ortheris. So this is known as your deltherium. Then you have a deltidium. Then you have a deltidium. Deltidium is closed by mean of TO calcite and plate which is called as a deltidium. This is the foramen, and this is what you can have a different kind of morphological characteristic. This is the foramen. This is a foramen. Foramen is the inward growth of deltidium due to the addition of the material leads to collapse of these two plates, giving rise to circular opening which is called as a foramen. Then you have a commissure. Then you have commissure. Commissure is a line along which TO wall are joined together anteriorly. There is a type of commissure. One is plica. When the commissure through creating rise in a commissure is called as a plica. Sulcus, when the commissioner down through creating a depression in compressure is called a sulcus. Then you have a different position of foramen. You have a different position of foramen. Bisulicate, unisulicate, and these all are the different kind of different position of foramen. This is a different type of shell. This is a different shape of the shell which we are going to, which we are now seeing on this slide. One is the rhombotric and the a triangle and all this shape of the brachiopods is present, and we will recognize this on the basis of this shapes only. Then next to this, what is the classification of the how we can classify the brachial bones? Adductor and deductor muscles. Adductor and deductor muscles. This muscle helps organism to open and close the wall. Adductor muscle, both the wall are closed by means of contraction and adductor muscle. Deductor muscle, both the wall are open by the means of extension of deductor muscle. Classification. So brachiopods have been classified on the basis of dentition system as class inarticulata, class articulata. So inarticulata and articulata is two different kind of classification which we generally use. Articulata forms without a dentition system, whereas the inarticulata forms which possess a dentition system. This is what difference between articulata and inarticulata. So forms without dentition system is this one. Then you have a different kind of so class articulata is forms with dentition system, which we already discussed what it means by articulata. You have a paleotremata. You have a paleotremata, which is older form with pedicle opening, which is older form with a pedicle opening. Ex rastrella, age of lower Cambrian, protremata, which forms a pseudo dentatium, which form a pseudo dentatium in young stage. Then you have what we can say the teletromata. Then you have a teletromata which have a highly modified pedicle opening and brachial skeleton. Then you have an ecology. So what is the ecology in which they are living in? Okay, we are living in such an atmosphere. We have some specific temperature set. We are used to take the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide and all. So this is what the environment we are living on. In such a way that each and every organism and fossil or each and every organism of earth is having some ecological habitat or ecological requirement in which they are living. So brachiopods are generally attached to seafloor. Brachiopods attached to the seafloor by means of pedicle on generally dead organism. Brachiopods attached to the seafloor by means of pedicles on generally dead organism. Rocky bottom, when the brachiopods buried under the sand, they use pedicle as an elevator to push themselves upward. So pedically attached, this ecological, this one is a pedically attached brachiopods, which attach to sea floor by means of pedicle on generally dead organism. Then you have an encrusted. When articulate forms attach themselves to the substrate, when articulate form attach themselves to the substrate with help of ventral wall, then you have a semi-infernal and semi-burrowing. When you have semi-infernal and semi-burrowing, inarticulate form live in a partially buried condition. Inarticulate form live in a partially buried condition. Free flying, when the brachiopods lying on a ocean floor when the pedicle opening is closed, that is a orthoids and all. Then what is the significance? What is the significance? The ornamentation. Smooth surface are better adapted for a current water condition, whereas the smoothness of shell minimize the friction and enhance stability. The ornamented shell are more resistant to hydrostatic pressure, that is rhinocolata. Then you have a recti marginate. Then you have a recti marginate. So this recti marginate commission is a adaptation of high energy condition so that used water can move away from the anterior outlet. The folded commission is a suggested that the organism which is live in a low energy condition. Hodlett Commission suggested that the organism which is live in a low energy condition. Then you have a zigzag commission. Adaptation of high turbidity and high energy condition. That is your zigzag commission. When you have a pedicle opening, The length and thickness of the pedicle stalk reflect upon the prevalent energy condition, as pedicle will be short and thicker in case of high energy condition. Pedicle will be large and thinner in case of low energy condition. So the size of pedicle will be suggested that what is the energy condition in the that particular ocean basin or whatever the where that all this branch of books is formed. So pedicle, that's why it's very much important to know about the energy condition as well as the low energy condition. So this is how you can have a different kind of important fossil. So this is what the convex shell surface smooth or with the growth lines. Then you have a productus with the spines radiating line and this one all. So this is how we can have important fossil in which one. This is one of the important fossil for the which is called a what we can say the brachiopod. So brachiopods is nothing but the which we consider as the one of the phylum and also having a same this one as a your what we can say the different kind of things are divided accordingly. So this is how your brachiopods is all about. So we have some other fossil also here we will discuss next. So after brachiopods we will now going to discuss about the phylum. Phylum Mollusca. So now I'm going to start next topic about the phylum Mollusca. Wait for a minute. So then we have a phylum Mollusca, which now we are going to study. Next fossil is a phylum Mollusca. Mollusca means Mollusca is a soft body animal. This phylum include the snail, mussels, kettles, fish, outcrop, etc. Show a variety of mode of life as a marine, benthic, sessile, mobile, nectic, freshwater and terrestrial one. So development of jet population system is the characteristic feature. Especially organism of class what we can say the phylum Mollusca. The development of jet propulsion system is the characteristic feature. What we can have the different kind of specially organism classes, cephalopoda. So where it is mostly occurred, in an oceanic division. This will be formed in an oceanic division. So in oceanic division, we have a epigenetic, photic, and this all the things are there. And now we have a class Lamellibranchia, the class Lamellibranchia. So what is the Lamellibranchia? This is a class. Lamellibranchia is nothing but a Lamellibranchia leaf-like grills. The Lamellibranchia is a leaf-like grip which having a bivalvia, which also have a modern name of this one is bivalvia, and this name is given to the organism of this class due to the possession of two equal walls, but shell is a inequilateral. Shell is a inequilateral for this one. Bivalvia name given by the Linnaeus in 1759. So the given the this what the what we can have this bivalvia name is given by the some of the very at the early 1758. So way back it is found. Then you have what is how the shell is made up of. The shell is a hard exoskeleton of the organism which is called the shell. Since both wall are equal and identical, they show the bilateral symmetry, where symmetry plane passing along a in between two identical walls. This is a brachiopod shell, how it is looks like. This is how the picture of brachiopods is look like. How the brachiopods picture is looks like. Then how what is the how the morphology is we are how the morphology is going there. So study of shape of organism. In morphology we study the shape of the organism. What then other than shape we have studied the morphology of an organism. Is an expression of environment. The shell of the organism is made up of three layer. The outer layer called perostractum, which is made up of chitin. The middle prismatic layer called ostracum, which is made up of calcite or aragonite. The inner layer called hypospectrum, which is made up of alternate lamellae or chitin calcite. Then you have a this is ambo. This is a what ambo we already also look in the bio brachiopods. This is the ambo. This is the anterior part, this is the posterior part, this is the growth line. This all are the study under the this one. This is a shell hinge. Then you have a hood, like what we have a so ambo is nothing but the elevated part on a dorsal view. Or ambo is nothing but the it can be a beak, the sharp and pointed end of the ambu. It is of three type of on the basis of pointing direction, as prosogy, opisogy, and orthogy. So this is a three different kind of this one. Now you have a hinge line. What the hinge line? We already discussed several times. Hinge line is nothing but a dorsal margin where two wall get separated. Where two wall get separated from each other by the single line, that is known as the hinge line. Then you have a lunule, that is a small heart shaped depressed portion anterior to the beak. Then you have a alatae. Then you have alatae, which is formed with the auricles, which is called alate. Then you have ligaments. Then you have ligaments, which is elastic tissue which helps to open the wall. On the basis of position, it has following type: prosodetic, opisodetic, and amphidetic. So this is a different kind of ligaments which we have. The adductor muscle scar are helps in closing to the of the wall by means of contraction. Due to contrast, due to constant activity of the adductor muscle, it causes a depressor circular area inside the wall. Marking the attachment of the adductor muscle, there may be one or two adductor muscle. If two adductor muscle are in identical, then it is called as a isomerian. This is called as a isomerian. Then you have a palial line. Then you have a palial line. The palial line is a linear marking of attachment of all mental muscles with the shell. So this is called as a palial line. Then you have a next part. Then we have a next part: dentition, ecology, geological distribution, and important fossil of bivalvia. Dentition of bivalvia. What is the dentition of bivalvia? Two walls are held together by means of dentral system, which present just below the ambo. Where the ambo is a elevated part. In that elevated part, we can say two walls are there which can be together. Then you have a classification of this dental system. Then you have a classification of dental system. On the basis of nature of hinge and shape of the number of teeth, dental system of bivalvia divided into following types: homodont and heterodont. Homodont and heterodont. Then you have a taxodont. Then you have a taxodont. Then you have a diastodont. Isodont. So this is a different kind of a symmetrical and asymmetrical wall which is present in the bivalve. Then you have a caesodont, heterodont. Heterodont, the teeth which is not are common in a uniform shape and size. In this type, teeth below the ambo called as the cardial teeth. In the teeth away from the ambo called the lateral teeth. That is a cardita, venous, and marked teeth. Then you have a desmodont. Then you have a desmodont. Pentadont. What is the pentadont? A dentition found only in form of Ordovician. A dentition which found only in form of Ordovician and Silurian form between the pentadont and. So what that kind of all the information where we are looking for, what the important things is where it occur. Where it occurs. So the pentadont and this all are the silurian form or Ordovician. So what kind of forms are there means in a different kind of environment you have a different kind of morphology. Okay, so this is the beauty of paleontology, or more we can say the microparentology, that they adapt the environment very quickly. And they mold themselves accordingly. And whatever the observation we are now after fossilization of that after the fossilization of this particular species, whatever the observation we are taking, means we are going through, that observation is nothing but the, what we can say, the are very important for point of view of knowing the environment. Knowing the environment of that study is very important. Then you have a cyclodont. Then you have a cyclodont. The straight hinge line is replaced by the curved hinge line, that is the cardium. The straight hinge line which is replaced by the curved hinge line is, example is the cardium. Then you have asthenodont. Then you have asthenodont. In this type of dentition, dentition is marked by the extended tongue like tooth just below the umbo. This is found in a burrowing animal, Excolos and Maia. Then you have ecology. What is the, how the ecology is get changed? So ecology is normal epiphonal benthic vagile form. This form are generally in equatorial and shallow burrows are there. Okay, so ecology for this one is normal epiphonal benthic vagile form. So on the basis of different forms, you have a different kind of morphology or ecology, what we can say. The Sirena is mostly found in a shallow water, whereas the Maia and Solane, these are the deep burrowers. They are living inside a very deep in the ocean. And so you have a different kind of forms in, on the basis of which you can have a different kind of organism. And you have a geological classification distribution of this animal. The range is from the Cambrian to present. So there is a large range of this this species. The range is very large, right from the Cambrian to the present. A large number of paleocypod have been reported from the rock of Silurian and Devonian. The freshwater forms, that is the Devonian, brackish water form, post-Devonian, Paleozoic form become extinct at the end of the era, and new forms appear throughout the world. Distribution in India, how it can be distributed. In Indian context, it is a fossil which is appeared in an Ordovician limestone of Spiti. This form is found in a Spiti, which is an Acephala fossil, appeared in a Ordovician limestone of Spiti. Avicolopetia and Cancocardian is a good index fossil for this one. Himalayan Triassic rock have a fossil of Megalodon. So in Himalaya, the Triassic rock is mostly having this kind of mollusca phylum in this study. So this is how it get be it get distributed throughout the world. The distribution pattern is in such a the distribution are in such a way that some of the important fossil which we study. This is a different type of important fossils: Unio, Trigonia. This is a fossil which are the part of this phylum Mollusca. So now we just take a one short view the how the, so the Mollusca are the soft body animal. So this phylum is include the snail, what you can say the snail and all, you generally seen that animal in the present scenario also, snail and all these cattlefish, octopus, this all are the type of Mollusca. These all are the just a type of Mollusca. We show the variety of mode of life such as marine, benthic, sessile, mobile, nectic, freshwater and terrestrial. So there is a large range. There is a large range of the how they are living in the some of the, what we can say, the in the taxa. So they are living from in a marine animal, in the benthic also, in the marine, in your sessile, mobile, nectic, this is a different kind of environment in the oceanic also. Then you have fresh water, just like lakes and whatever the river we are dealing with in a terrestrial environment. So development of a jet population propulsion system is characterized feature. The specifically organism class the cephalopoda. The cephalopoda is one of the organism. This is the oceanic division where it can be living on. So you can have a benthic and abyssal plane where you have this class. Then you have a bivalvia. Then you have a bivalvia. Then you have a pelycypoda. Then you have a pelycypoda. The lamellibranchia. The lamellibranchia is a leaf-like grill. Lamellibranchia is a leaf-like grill. Generally, one pair of grill, lamella, is generally a one pair limb. Then you have bivalvia. Then you have bivalvia, which is a modern name. This name is given to the organism of this class due to the position of two equal valve. But shell is a inequilateral. Shell is a inequilateral. So shell is a hard exoskeleton of the organism which is called the shell. Shell is a hard exoskeleton of the organism which is called shell. Since both walls are equal, since both walls are equal and identical, they show a bilateral symmetry where symmetry plane passing along the in between the, this one. So this is how you can have a different kind of mollusca type are there. So then you have monomyrian and all this different kind of hairy dentition and all the different kind of bivalvia. So on the basis of their teeth and all, they are classified. So hinge line is straight, so they are known as the taxo. This is a taxodont and dinosodont. So this is a different typical name to the species depending upon their morphological characteristic. So what we are studying from this one, what we are going to study and what we are going to know from studying this all the animal and fossil, that's for animal and fossil or micro fossil and all are the very much sensitive for the environmental changes. They are very much specifically the animal which is soft and this one soft body animal, they are very much what we can say the sensitive to the environmental changes whatever. So if there is any environment change, if there is any environmental change is happen, they are the first to respond to this changes. So when we are post fossilization, we study this one. These are the very helpful to know about the past climatic condition, past environment, ecology, what kind of processes is operating that now, and what kind of things is going into the this world. So this is how you can you can have this organism and how you can study this fossil. So today we just seen the two different kind of fossil. One is a brachiopoda, one is a brachiopoda, and another one is a phylum. So phylum and brachiopoda, two type of mollusca and brachiopods, two type of we already seen this one, and both these are in mostly remain in the oceanic surface and all. So what is the use of this this study? So you can have this kind of study for the paleoclimatic reconstruction, paleo temperature. So if the any fossil, if the any fossil is living in the what we can say the any fossil which is living in the environment, this environment can easily deduce from this one. This environment can be easily deduced from the this one. So so this is how you can have this is how you can have a different kind of animals, different kind of phylum, and this all which we are study under the this microparent project Palindrome, and this is how we can apply it for this one. So thank you for listening this one. Hope you have some idea about now this one. You can have a better understanding after reading the books and the available resources in the net. So this is all about the phylum Mollusca and Brachiopods. Now you can study and read more about the morphology and which can be used for the your paleontological study and the morphological study. It's nowadays it's a very good topic to study because there is a many organism still we can find this organism. You can give your name also by following the norm of a classification scheme for the paleontology. But yes, this is a what we can say the good topic to be explored, and also for the examination point of view, we have some question on this brachiopods and mollusca and all. So thank you for listening this lecture. Hope you understand this all. Now I'm going to close this one. Thank you.